Hello. My name is Morgan Quigley. I'm here to talk about ROS 2 and Gazebo 4, some of the latest and greatest that we're working on over at the Open Source Robotics Foundation. Let's see here. Okay, there we go. Yeah, so we're a small nonprofit research lab down in Mountain View. There's about 15 or 20 of us. We have a few big projects we work on. ROS, the robot operating system, kind of a way to glue robot software together. Gazebo is a simulation framework that oftentimes is used with ROS, and then a few others as well. Lots of sponsors kindly supporting us in our efforts there. So ROS 2 is what we're working on for a little while now. It's quite different from ROS 1. We're hoping that the user experience will be very similar, conceptually similar, but under the hood, kind of everything is different. ROS 1 has been underneath, and kind of if you peel all the layers back of all the nice stuff on top, it's really just a bunch of TCP sockets that are blasting at each other. And that's great until it's totally broken, depending on your network configuration. So that was, we did that stuff back in 2007. That was a long time ago. Lots of other interesting middleware frameworks and other stuff you can just grab off the shelf has since come out. One of which is called DDS, or Data Distribution Service, which is a standardized middleware framework. There's at least a dozen implementations out there, some open source, some closed source, some that have all sorts of acronyms saying they're certified for all sorts of interesting applications. It's used by a lot of what I call grown-up applications. Like, these are zillion-dollar projects. That's the Grand Coulee Dam there, the biggest hydroelectric station in the States. It runs this thing, so obviously it apparently can work for a while without crashing. Some of the benefits you get from this DDS system, you can do a masterless discovery, so you just kind of launch programs and they just find each other on your network. Very extensive quality of service, so groups like NASA will use it to handle the latency required to like talk to a Mars rover, for example. Or you can use it on a local network where it essentially can devolve just to UDP blasting. So very capable and complex system, but it's complicated to use, of course, with all these features. So what we're hoping to do is combine all the user-friendly, robot-friendly tools that we've had so far in the ROS ecosystem with this advanced capability. And this will be in parallel with ROS 1, so don't worry, we're not going to break ROS 1. It's, it'll kind of keep going by itself. And to put in cartoons there, essentially ROS 1, we had just this big block of monolithic code, which was both the userland API and all the sort of middleware that was baked into it. We're breaking that out and abstracting the various layers in ROS 2, so you can have the client API, then an abstract middleware API, where beneath that, the default implementation will be this abstract DDS API, which will then be able to target a number of different DDS applications, depending if you want the open source ones, or if you have license for the closed source ones, or anything in between. We're hoping to address more than just the running on Linux case, which we primarily do now. So this will be capable someday of Windows, small real-time operating systems we're working on every day now, and even bare metal. And lots of different physical layers beneath also. Okay, so now on the Gazebo side of things, Gazebo is a big simulation project we've been working on for a while. It's primarily in the past been used with the Open Dynamics engine. And let's see if I can get a video to play here. It'd be kind of fun. Oh boy, going downhill here. Okay, there we go. So this is fun. Now what we're trying to do with Gazebo is you can have the same controller code and target multiple physics engines. So the same controller code, and there's just something awesome about million-dollar robots face planning, right? This is the Atlas robot from the DARPA Robotics Challenge, and this is kind of part of our overall effort to support that effort. Let's see, so you can run now the Open Dynamics engine, the Bullet Physics engine, SimTK, which is out of Stanford here, the Dart, which comes from Georgia Tech. And the most important thing is we have the same controller code running against multiple physics engines and multiple parameters. Now you can tweak the physics fidelity and versus the CPU complexity there, so that number in the upper right, the real-time factor, you can sort of burn more CPU time to get a better simulation. The different physics engines will have different properties. Some of them handle contacts better, some of them are just faster to run, some of them have more interesting bells and whistles you can use. And depending on the application, it's there's different things you might want to try. Let's see, so more stuff in Gazebo. People are using it with RoboCup teams, with FIRST Robotics. We've got first class support now for the Oculus headset and Hydra. You can pull real terrains. Also working it in cloud-based, where it's a browser-based front-end, but the back-end, the physics, the sensor generation is all in the cloud, so you can, there's a picture of an iPad and whatever else. So that's it, there's some links. I'm happy to take questions at the coffee break or at lunch. Thanks.